Hello everyone. I think all of us hate the chromatic aberration when we go to a beautiful scene, we take the photos, come back home, import the photos to Lightroom, and when we zoom to the corners of our photos, we see unwanted colors like magenta or purple or something like that. And today I just want to show you my easy way, my fast way to take off all these colors without using Photoshop. Maybe I will use Photoshop when I feel that the photo is complicated and I have to make more than one layer. So let's go to Lightroom and begin with the process. So let's take this photo as an example. This photo is a part of this photo which made of panorama. You can see the whole editing process of this photo in the link which you can see right now. So let's zoom here to the corner of this photo. As you can see, there's a lot of purple and magenta of this branch here, and if I click this remove chromatic aberration, it takes some of them, but you feel just still like blue color or magenta or something like that. So what I will do, I will go to the color panel right here to the saturation, and I will choose this one, and I will point to the color that I see, and as you can see, it's telling me that still blue and purple, and I can just click and take them down, and as you can see, it took all the saturation, the blue and the purple. So this is before and this is after. This is before and this is after. But the problem is that maybe I have a photo where there's a lot of purple color, like for example building or something like that, and I have a blue sky, and I don't want to take the saturation and purple color from the whole photo. I just want to take it from the corner or from the place where there's a chromatic aberration. So let's take this photo as another example. If you want to see how I took this photo, here is the link. And as you can see, this photo I have a lot of colors, and that's why I can't make like last photo. But if I zoom in here, you can see I have a lot of, just a minute, I have a lot of chromatic aberration here and the same here. And I know there's a lot of people don't care about that, but I don't like to have chromatic aberration, and there's a lot of photo contest doesn't accept the photo when there's chromatic aberration like that. Here I don't feel I have a lot of chromatic aberration. So what I will do right now, I will zoom here and I will see what color I have to take off. I think the magenta, the purple, the blue, and I think the red also. There's still, as you can see, there's still chromatic aberration. Now I feel there's no chromatic aberration. So as I said, I will open this photo in Adobe Photoshop. Now I have this photo without chromatic aberration and without any color in the photo. So I will come back to my photo here and I will go to the final editing that I did, and I will open also in Photoshop. So now after having the both photo, this is the without chromatic aberration and this is the normal photo, I will take this and I will select and copy it and paste it here. And I will make layer mask, and I will go just to the parts in the photo where I feel there's chromatic aberration, and I will just take the brush and I will apply the mask. And I have to be careful because, as you can see, if I choose a big color, you feel I am affecting the sky and other colors. So that's why I have to make the brush small as much as I can. So as you can see, this is the before and this is the after. And obviously there's magenta color and red color. And the same thing here. As you can see, this is the red line here. I will take this red line, so this is the before and this is the after. And the same thing here, I think there's also a little bit of chromatic appreciation in this area here. So as you can see, it's not complicated, it's not so hard, just you have to be sure you are not affecting big areas. As you can see here, I have also here chromatic appreciation. You have just to be sure you are not affecting big areas, or you are not affecting the whole photo. So as you can see, this is the before, after. So that was my way. As you have just seen, it's not complicated, it's easy and fast. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you want to see other videos in the future, please subscribe, and see you next week. Bye.